today is Thursday, 3/26/20, and today for math, we're going to be going over two things. For topic 11, we're going to do the vocabulary review sheet and the reteaching. Now, these are not set up like the other lessons. It doesn't have a green box that you click on, so you're going to have to look for those sheet names, vocabulary review, and the vocabulary review sheet just looks like this. It'll be in color on the screen, but I didn't print in color. And then the reteaching looks like this. It says reteaching, topic 11 at the top, okay? And that's two pages. There's A and B, and then C and D is on the next page. So we're going to go over both of those today. And remember, I said if you can't print it, that's absolutely fine. Just write your answers on a piece of paper and send that to me, okay? Because tomorrow is test day, so that's why we're doing vocabulary and reteaching today, because it's our study guide. All right, so we're going to go over the vocabulary review sheet first. So number one and two, you're just going to be understanding the vocabulary. So number one says subtract the tens shown by the model. So let me go ahead and write this out. Like tens. Trying to do it exactly like it is on yours so you can follow right along with me. Okay. Okay, so this is what you have to start out with. And our vocabulary word that we're looking at is tens. So tens are these big long sticks. They look like sticks. And if we were to use a saddle box, our tens would be a ten rod. So we know that this whole thing has ten in it. So this is one group of ten. We know this is our one, okay? So if we look at our groups of ten, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the reason I'm saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 instead of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 is because in this problem, it says blank tens. It doesn't say blank subtract blank. It wants to know the groups of 10. So first, this first blank, since we're subtracting, you have to start with our largest number. So we're going to do however many we have all together. So I've got 6 tens. So 6 is going to go in that first blank. And then look at your tens, guys, on your paper and see how many of those tens have a line through them. Okay, and if you look, I see one group that has a line through it, 2, and 3. If you guys agree with me, just nod your head real quick. Okay. So we're going to, our subtraction problem is going to say 6 tens subtract 3 tens equals, and then how many tens do you have left that were not marked through? Well, I've got 1 group, 2 group, 3 group. So 6 tens subtract 3 tens equals 3 tens. That's all you need for number 1. Now, number 2, we're going to do that the same way. Let me see if I can erase this and leave my little setup the same. Okay, number 2. Draw my tens. Okay, so I counted 8 tens to start with. And then, okay. So that's what yours looks like on your paper. Except your tens blocks look a little prettier than mine, because remember, I'm just drawing them. I don't have any 10 blocks up here. Okay, so using our model, blank tens. Now remember, this is how many we started with. So if we count them, we started with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we started with 8 tens. And then how many tens did have a line through them? Go ahead and count those on your own. Okay, on the count of three, I want you to whisper how many tens have a line through. 1, 2, 3, 6. It's like I can hear you guys coming through my speaker. So 6 tens have a line through them. So 8 tens subtract 6 tens equals how many tens left without a line through them? And if I circle them, so you can see them just a little bit better, I have 2 tens left. Okay? All right, moving on to number 3. Board is not going to erase lately. I think I've used it too much. All right, so number 3, it gives you a subtraction problem. So it gives you the subtraction problem. 50 subtract 30 equals blank. And it says, pick or circle the addition problem that's going to help me solve this subtraction problem. So now this is, we're going to kind of flip-flop it around. This is kind of going to be a fact family. So we're looking for the missing piece to our fact family. So let's see. Let me write my answers up here. 10 plus 40 is 50. So I've got my four problems. So 10 plus 40 is 50, 25 plus 25 is 50, 30 plus 20 is 50, and 40 plus 10 is 50. Now we have to look at all four of these problems and see which ones have the same numbers that's given me my subtraction problem. Well, if we go on, let me get a different color marker so you guys can see. If I look at this first one, does this problem have a 10 in it? Nope. What about a 40? Nope. Okay, but it does have a 50. But since it didn't have the 30 in it, we can't use that one. So we know that one's not it. Now let's look at this problem, the second one. Does this problem up here, our subtraction problem, does it have 25 in it? Nope. Doesn't have 25. And it does have the 50, but we said since it didn't have either one of those add-ins in it, it can't be that one. Okay, now let's look at this one. 30, there's a 30 down here. Is there a 30 up here in my subtraction problem? Yes, okay. What about 20? Okay, well there's not a 20 up here. What about a 50? There's a 50 here and a 50 here. Yes, it does have a 50. Okay, so that one is possible because it's got two of the numbers. Remember, we don't really know what goes here yet. We're trying to figure out the addition problem that would help us. Okay, and then down here at the bottom, does the subtraction problem have a 40 in it? No. Does it have a 10 in it? No. All it has is a 50, so we can't use that one. The reason that we can use this problem, 30 plus 20 equals 50, is because it's got two of the same numbers. So it's got the 50, so we started with 50, and we subtracted 30, and we would end up with 20. So if we flip-flop that to how it is down here, we would look at the number that we're subtracting and our difference, and we would add those two together to get our answer, okay? So we would say 30 plus 20. Now, does that equal 50? It does. So that one works. So you need to circle 30 plus 20 equals 50. Remember, when you are asked to find one that will help, or find an addition problem that will help you subtract, it needs to have the same numbers as it would in the subtraction problem. At least two. Alright. And number four says solve 40 subtract 20 using a number chart. So I've got my handy dandy hundreds chart here. But my tape is gone, so I cannot stick it to my board. That's okay. Let me see. Will this work? Maybe I can clip it up here. There we go. That'll work. Okay. So on our hundreds chart, it says 40 subtract 20. So on my hundreds chart, I'm going to start with the largest number since we're subtracting, which is 40, so 40. Now, remember to jump a 10 to go, or I'm sorry, to subtract the 10, I'm just going to go up a row. So if I wanted to subtract 20, that's two groups of 10, so I would have to go up not one row, but two. So 40 subtract 20 would give me 20. Okay, and you can, on yours, over here, you don't have to mark out every single one of them. Just go up the decade numbers like I did. Okay. Number five. Use mental math to solve 70 subtract 10. Alright, so 70 subtract 10. So I can think about it as, there's my 70. If I take one of these away, I'm going to be left with 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So 70 subtract 10 is 60. So think of those place value blocks in your head, okay? And number six at the bottom, it wants you to solve 80 subtract 50 using an open number line. So when we use an open number line and we're subtracting, we're going to start with the biggest number, so 80. It's going to be over here on the right side, okay? Because remember, we work backwards when we subtract. And then we have to jump back 50 times. So that's going to be 5 groups of 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now all I need to do is fill in my numbers. So 80, the 10 in front of 80 would be 70, 60, 50, 40, and 30. Make sure your numbers line up underneath your tick marks, and let's just do our 5 jumps back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now remember, each time we went back 10, so 80 subtract 50 was 30, okay? And the next sheet we're going to be looking at is reteaching. And I apologize in advance, this video is going to be a little bit longer than I anticipated, but if you guys do it with me, I'll fill out every single problem on the study guide with you. Okay? Set A at the top. So this is our teaching page. Make sure you're on this page. Set A at the top says you can subtract tens. So you can subtract, or I'm sorry, over here it says you need to subtract 30, which is 3 tenths. So we started with 40. So it says we need to subtract 30, which is 3 tenths. So we're going to cross out 30, which would be 3 groups. So 1, 2, 3. 40 subtract 30 is 10. Okay? Numbers 1 and 2 to the right, so like this is the one we just did, to the right of that, numbers 1 and 2 in set A. That's what we're going to do right now. So it's already got your plus value box drawn for you. So I just need to draw mine. Over here, 60 subtract 40. I started with 60. I'm going to take 40 away, which means four groups. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm left with two groups of 10, which would be 20. 50 subtract 20. I started with 50, five groups of 10. I'm going to take two of those groups away, and I am left with 10, 20, 30. Alright, that was set A. Set B at the bottom. Says you can use a hundreds chart to subtract tens as well. So let me get my hundreds chart back up here. And now, remember, they've just given you a partial hundreds chart, so that lets you know that it's the same thing. It's just letting you know that you don't need to go outside of those numbers to solve. So, the example problem it gives you is 80 subtract 20. So, I'm going to start at 80. And I'm going to jump up two rows because I'm subtracting 20. So, that would be two groups of 10. So, that would be one group of 10 and two groups of 10. I end up at 60. Okay? And then, for problems 3 and 4, you're going to use that partial hundreds chart. You may just want to use your finger under your jumps since you've got two problems to do. That way you don't get confused. So number 3 says 70 subtract 20. So I'm going to start at 70. To jump 20, I'm going to jump up. I'm going to go up two groups of 10. So 1, 2, 70 subtract 20 gives me 50. And number 4, we're starting at 60, and I'm jumping back 10. Now, does that mean I'm going to do 10 jumps? No, because that means I will jump back 100. So jump 10, I'm just going to go one time, and I land at 50. So 60 subtract 10 is 50. Okay, and we are on the last page now. Set C at the top. It says you should use mental math to subtract tens. Now, I know this one's a little harder. It's a little harder to think about it in our heads than it is to have those manipulatives that we use. So that's why over here it has given you the actual blocks, but it's not over here. But if you need to, draw your blocks, okay? Alright, so number 5 says 60. 2 subtract 10. Now I am going to draw it to help you guys out, to help you see it visually. So maybe try to think about it. 62, if I take 10 of those away, how many is it going to be? And then watch my picture if you're not really sure. So 62. So there's my 62. Now, I'm only taking 10 away, so I'm going to put an X through one of those. My 10th digit is going to change. My one digit stays the same. So now in the 10th place, I'm going to have 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. But in my 1th place, I still have 2. So 62 subtract 10 is 52. Okay, number 6 says 89. Subtract 10 equals blank. Alright, let's draw it. 89. Alright, so I had to put those down at the bottom. Ran out of room. So 89 subtract 10, I'm just going to put a mark through one of my 10s. Now, I know that my 1's digit is going to stay the same, so I'm going to go ahead and put my 9 in my 1's place. And then I'm just going to count my tens. So I've got 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So 89 subtract 10 gives me 79. And for number 7, now we're going to do this one in our head. 27 subtract 10 equals, okay, now let's follow the rules we've been doing. Each time we're subtracting 10, my tens digit goes down one number, but my ones digit stays the same. So my ones digit over here is still going to be a 7. And my tens digit, which is a 2, is going to go down by 1. So if I have 20 right now, and I take 10 of those away, how many do I have? 10. So to put a 10, to show 10 in the tens place, all you're going to do is write a 1 in front of that 7. So 27 subtract 10 is going to give you 17. And number 8, at the bottom, it just says write an equation to solve. Use drawings and models to show your work. A store has 50 toy boats. So how many boats does the store have? Good, 50. That's our number we're going to start with. They sell 10 of those boats. So 10 of those boats are now gone. How many toy boats does the store have now? So remember, when we're writing an equation, if we are getting rid of something, if we're selling it, taking it away, how many do they have now? It lets you know you're going to subtract. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a subtraction symbol in my circle. You've seen this on your math sheets. And now we're going to fill in the numbers that we do know. So the numbers I have are 50 and 10. Well, I already said that 50 is our largest number, so it's going to go first. When you subtract, you always start with the biggest number. So 50 subtract 10. So I started with 50 boats. I took 10 of those boats away. And then you're going to have to figure out how many boats are here. And it wants you to draw a model in that rectangle at the bottom. Draw a model to go with it. And at the bottom it says blank toy boats. Make sure you write the number of boats that goes here. Okay, so make sure you put your difference down here on this line. All right, guys, I know this is a longer video. Thanks for sticking it out with me, though. If you have any problems about the study guide or the test, just let me know, okay? Make sure you take your time and make sure you answer all parts of the question. Okay, bye.